So it seemed as though the Snow White backlash was starting to quiet down, with Rachel Zegler being busy performing Romeo and Juliet on Broadway, so she wasn't really doing many interviews, therefore lowering any chance of sparking outrage from people online. However, she recently accepted an interview with Variety in which she was asked about the Snow White backlash, and her response has once again led to the public being outraged at not just one thing she said in the interview, but two. With the first part being where she stated that she has watched women get torn down her entire life, and implied that that is the underlying reason for why she's being attacked over Snow White, which as you can imagine has led to a massive amount of backlash from the public. But then the second point, also polarizing the internet, is where she says the following. As she recalled the hate that erupted during the Snow White backlash, she said, "In all honesty, it made me sad that it was taken in such a way, because I believe that women can do anything, but I also believe that they can do everything." Zegler says that what she meant to convey was that Snow White wants romance, but also has other goals. However, people have been quick to respond to her saying this by playing an old interview of hers, where she seems to explicitly say that this new Snow White movie isn't about love or war. So I think her new response here suggests that possibly the reshoots that they did may have been working some romance back into the movie, but I'll touch on that later, as the first point I wanted to analyze here was where she said that women being torn down was the major reason for a Snow White backlash. And of course, with this being such a hot, divisive topic online right now, I'm going to focus on the facts of the situation and statement in order to cut out all the hearsay. So if we take her statement there at face value, it would suggest that whenever a young woman is cast in such a massive role, people will be looking for any excuse to cut her down. So let's take a look at the previous Disney live-action remakes, in which almost all have focused on female characters, which definitely makes this all the more easier to analyze. So a massive live-action remake they made back in 2015 was Cinderella, in which there really wasn't any controversy around the movie at all, and by all accounts, the main actress had a pretty smooth and seemingly ride while marketing and filming the movie. And while it's not Disney, we can also look at the Cinderella movie made in 2021, which starred Camila Cabello, who, like Rachel Zegler, is of Hispanic descent, and she also didn't receive anywhere near the type of backlash that Rachel Zegler did. In fact, James Corden received more backlash for that movie than Camila Cabello did. And then we can also look at the 2019 Disney live-action Beauty and the Beast, in which Emma Watson received virtually no backlash for that one too, or at least once again not anywhere near the level of backlash that Rachel Zegler received. And then we get to the most recent comparison, being the Little Mermaid movie, which was also extremely divisive and caused a lot of backlash, but once again, it seemed to be more focused on the movie and the casting, and it never really got as personal towards Halle Bailey as it did towards Rachel Zegler. In fact, one of the loudest voices in the online criticism of Rachel Zegler's Snow White being the critical drinker had this to say in regards to Halle Bailey and her Little Mermaid movie.
It's not until you step back for a minute and think about the two different actresses that you realise how this interview is trying to manipulate you. Because in a nutshell, these two people are not alike at all. First up, let's consider Halle Bailey and the journey she's been on so far. She definitely took some heat for her role in The Little Mermaid, mostly because she was playing a race-war version of a historically white character. Now, you could debate the merits of that argument as much as you like, but the point here is that what most people had a problem with was Bailey's casting, not Bailey as a person. Why? Because she gave them no reason to. She generally came across as pretty charming and likable in interviews and press junkets, just another actress doing her job and excited to be taking on such a big role. She didn't feel the need to bite back at her detractors, she didn't criticise the original movie for its lack of diversity, and she didn't disrespect her own co-stars or act like she was entitled to even more than she already had. This was a very smart move on her part, because she largely avoided the controversy swirling around the movie, and today,